Well, I was on maternity leave last year when they introduced the taxation to the maternity benefit, and I was absolutely horrified by their aggressive move, but I wasn't in any position back then to be able to do anything. So when they introduced another cut this time around, I felt I had to act. €32 reduction in maternity benefit is a direct attack on women and families, and it will be a significant impact on families who are already struggling with reduced income and increased costs.
I think the result is that women, working women, are going to be find it more and more difficult to have children. The income that they'll get while they're on maternity leave is going to be drastically reduced. And this is happening at a time when a lot of companies and the community sector, I work in the community sector, don't have the money to pay the difference where people's wages would have previously may have been topped up.
€32 may not seem like an awful lot to somebody on a ministerial or a TD salary, but to the average working family, it means an awful lot. So I say to you, shame on you, Joan Burton. You should know better.
We have just seen, particularly Joan Burton, to be anti-woman and anti-family. And I think we all need to stand together and say, no, women have rights to have children. Women have rights to have choices as to their work. And women have a right to have a decent quality of a standard of living when they become a mother. We have all been failed by this government.
The Women's Council is very opposed to this cut in maternity benefit. It comes at a time when, you know, we need to be keeping rates at the same rate or increasing them, not cutting them back. So what we need is for the government to reverse this cut, because it's bad for women, it's bad for children, it's bad for families, it's bad for society.
And Bernardo's have estimated that if you include the taxation of benefit and the cut, that women over the course of their maternity leave stand to lose about £3,500. For a woman on a low income, that is a lot of money. And what it will do is, I think, force women, particularly poorer women and women on low incomes, back into work sooner than they might choose to do.